What's up, guys? My name is Spencer Turley. Oh, God. You gotta love the old school vids, dude. Hey, if any of you guys remember those days, you're a day one dudeski for sure. So, either way, had us a fun race on Daytona 125s. If you're not in my Discord already, what the hell are you doing? Go hit me up on Instagram, Spencer Turley, no space, no capital. Hit me up in a DM. I'll get you in my Discord. Or hit me up on Snapchat, Spencer Turley, no space, no capital. And I will get you in my Discord that way. So, yeah, man, we've been having a lot of fun doing some random, like, 125 fun races and doing some supercross practice and all different kinds of stuff, man. I mean, even if you don't want to like try out for the team or anything like that, you can still shop in and have fun with us, man. We got basically a full gate every time we get on a supercross track. I know that since we got in here on the 125s, it wasn't really like a full gate because a lot of people didn't really want to ride on 125s. I don't know. I guess they were scared of the power band. I'm not really sure, but as soon as we went back to the 450s, the gate was full again. So either way, man, have me a little battle here with a Galaxy dudeski. Check this out. Oh my God. So he didn't hit that triple. I was like, fuck. Then I got around him. Oh my God. Oh yeah, dog. Banging bars, dude. You couldn't have done that before JLV did that little, front end lock update that he put in like a couple months ago. You couldn't have done that for shit. You'd have instantly went down. So that has certainly helped the game a little bit, but you can bang bars a little bit more than you could have beforehand. But either way, dude, it's been forever since I got in here and done a 125 race. This first race that we did on Daytona, I was a little off. As you can see, I'm like tiptoeing in my Jordans, like barely even moving. And then the second race, I started getting it going again. But it's interesting when you go to all the different bikes and stuff in the game and trying to relearn, because all of them have a little bit of a different, like, inertia and weight feeling to them. You know, they all feel a little bit different, but mainly the point of this video is just going here and show you a couple little funny moments I had in this race, and just letting everybody know we've been getting in there on Discord every single night on MXSim. If you don't have anybody else to ride with or whatever, you just want to get on there and have some fun, we've been getting at it, dog, for sure. Like, what I basically do is I'll go in there and have like one or two more so like serious nights where we're really kind of like practicing and training. Then I'll go in there and throw like a crazy fun night where it's like 125s only on Daytona, or it's like riding on one of my custom tracks, or it's 500s on this other track. You know, I try to definitely keep a balance between like fun and seriousness with it. So, but I just wanted to make it clear to all you guys that still aren't in my Discord, because I have like maybe, I don't know, 300-400 people in Discord or something like that. Obviously I have way more subscribers than that, you know what I mean? So there's a lot of you guys out there, I'm sure you've always wanted to get into my Discord, you just never have or never found a reason. This is something I kind of really just now started doing to the level that I am right now. Really getting in there and playing MX Simulator every single night, letting random people join in on my Discord and play with us. So I haven't ever really done this before, so I just wanted to kind of make this little announcement here. Like, if you want to get involved, get into playing some MX Sim, we've been taking it back to the golden days, taking it back to the, you know, the tracks with no erode and just having fun, man. Like, there's nothing else like it in this game, I'm telling you. So it's just so much fun to do that when you got damn near a full gate of people. Like, it's unexplainable, it really is. So if you haven't like really been into MX Simulator past couple years, or you've kind of fallen out of love with the game, you know, whether it be from a road or the unprofessionalism from RF or whatever, you know, get up in a corner and turn in a corner and get protested and suspended. So, you know, if you're, I could see where a lot of people could kind of be on some weird vibes when it comes to how they feel about MX Simulator the past couple years. But just saying, if you want to get back in here and have some fun, hit me up. Instagram, Snapchat, Spencer Turley, no space, no capital. Check this shit out right here. Lapper, where you going, dog? He was like, left, right, left. Dude fucking punts me to another planet and back. I stayed up on the bike. What the hell was that? Oh, I had no idea where that lapper was going to go. It was like left, and he was like right, and he was like, I don't know where I'm going to go. Spencer's right behind me. What am I going to do? So I got to just fucking slow down to like, you know, -5 miles an hour. Then the dude behind me that was racing me, he bunted me all the way off the track. Oh, dude, it's so much fun. Like, that racing experience and like running into each other and shit, like, that's so fun, dude. I can't explain how you just don't get that anywhere else other than sitting down and really racing in this game and having fun and doing weird shit like riding 125s and, you know, doing all that kind of stuff is what makes these funny moments and these fun moments and these cool different things happen in the game, right? That's what makes it happen, is when you go in there and do all that. But you got to have people, you know what I mean? And a lot of people just don't have enough people, and that's really what it comes down to. A lot of servers just don't have enough people in them anymore. A lot of, so it's almost like the game is kind of the errors being cut off to the game from the inside, you know what I mean, in a way. And it makes it to where it's really hard for like just some random person to go hop on a random server and have fun. I mean, honestly, it's really hard for people to do that now if you're not involved with the team or you're not doing anything like that. So my main goal here to explain to some of you guys, if you're not on a team, you're having trouble finding a full server, you're not really having very much fun with the game, come to my Discord, come hang out with us, come play some Sim. I'm telling you, dudes, this is where it's at. We've been having a shitload of fun. I think the most we had on a gate yesterday was like 21 people or 20 people on a supercross track. And let me tell you, when you got 21, 22 people on a supercross track, you feel like you're in a fucking like pro race, you know? It takes it to another level when you get full gates like that. But yeah, I was relearning this 125. Good God, Spencer, looked like a fucking novice beginner ass. Dude, I'm telling you, when you get so used to like riding on the 450 and then all of a sudden you're like back in on a 125, it takes me like a solid 5, 6, 7 races to get it back on a different bike, you know. It like really takes me a little bit of time because it's hard to figure out like what gear you need to be in, what the bike's going to do reaction wise especially going from a 450 to a 125. It wouldn't be as weird of a transition if I was going from like a 250 to a 125, but going from that big old honking 450 all the way back to the little zinger, it definitely is a change, you know. It's about the biggest change you can make in the game. I guess going from a 450 to a 50 would technically be the biggest change, but you know what I'm saying, like it's a big change, dog. Don't even look at my lap times right now. I don't even know if I ran a lap without wrecking, but, yeah. So, and the interesting part is like trying to figure out which lines you can hit on the 450 and which ones are going to translate on the 125 and which ones you're not going to be able to hit on the 125. So it's this constant like guessing game. But once you run, you know, about 2 or 3 races on that individual track on the 125, then you can start figuring out which lines you can hit, which lines you can't hit, which lines are feasible, you know. But we've been having a lot of fun, dude. I'm telling you, like, it's been a good old time. Been in Discord just chatting it up, like, just chilling, you know, having fun. Like, it's not too serious, but yet you can get in some fun battles and some serious battles and shit. And if you do want to get on the team still, I am doing my team tryouts. If you do want to get on there, I'll just put you in my team tryout role in my Discord. And once you start getting in there consistently and playing with us every night, that's basically what I base it off of who I'm putting on the team, is how consistently you get on. And then I'll get in there and just kind of see how you are as a person, right? Let me blow that berm out to Texas. And then that's how I end up putting you on the team. So, yeah, we're still doing the team tryout stuff. We'll still be doing that for another 2-3 weeks. So any guys that aren't already in my Discord or, you know, getting on there playing with us every night, we're basically the top of the server when it comes to like Supercross, the top of the server list on there. So, you know, you'll see us on there if you don't want to get in the Discord and you just want to ride and play. But yeah, dude, either way, oh my God, just wanted to come here and make a fun little video on this. Thought it was funny. A couple little collision moments I had with that dude ski. It's a good old time, man. So either way, appreciate you guys watching all the videos. A lot more fun 125 races to come. All of you guys that are getting involved in my Discord, getting involved in the community, that's my team helmet right there that dude ski's wearing. Got a little glimpse of it there. So yeah, getting all custom stuff made for the team, so it's pretty sick. But I'll be going over that in some other videos in the future. But I also want to get in there and really start recording all of us in Discord while we're racing and while we're riding. You know what I mean? Because that's going to take it to a whole nother level. So once I start doing that, it'll be a lot of fun. But I just want to come here and do a quick little video over the gameplay of one of the 125 fun races that we did. So, yeah, dude, it's no telling what we're going to be doing. But I always warn you guys, like, every night before I get on, when I'm going to get on, what bikes we're going to be on, what tracks we're going to be on. So as long as you kind of stay involved in my Discord, my general chat in my Discord, you'll have a very well understanding of what's going on my server and stuff like that. So either way, appreciate all the support. Have a good day, boys. Later.